In this video, I'm going to be discussing how to find a confidence interval for the population mean when sigma is unknown. And I will be using example 8.8 from the free online introductory statistics book, which you can get via this link here. Okay, so let's first start by reading through the question. Suppose you do a study of acupuncture to determine how effective it is in relieving pain. You measure sensory rates for 15 subjects, and you get these results. Okay, so this is our data down here. Use this data to construct a 95% confidence interval, so we want 95% confidence, for the mean sensory rate for the population. Okay, and we're going to assume that this data is normally distributed. That is an important assumption. Okay, and we're going to be doing this in Excel. But if you go to the textbook, they also show you how to do it with these different calculators. Okay, so but what's the basic idea? I have this data, and first thing I want to do is figure out what is the sample mean, right? What is the sample mean? Then once I have figured out the sample mean, I'm basically going to find some sort of buffer zone around that sample mean, okay? So we'll have a lower limit and an upper limit that we're 95% confident that somewhere in that interval, the population mean is somewhere in there, all right? So step one, figure out your sample mean X bar. So go ahead and pull open Microsoft Excel and basically just copy this data over. So our first data point is 8.6, 9.4, 7.9, etc. Let me just keep doing this. All right, so there we go. I have all 15 data points here in column A. Maybe make it a little smaller so we can see all 15 at the same time, okay? All right, and so the very first thing I want to do is figure out X bar, or the sample mean. And so find a cell, press enter, and then write average, okay? So the function in Excel for mean is average. So type average, open parentheses, click on your first data observation, and hold the click until you get down to the bottom, close those parentheses, for the average, and then press enter. All right, and there we go. The average is 8.22666, etc. Okay? All right, the next thing I need to know is the standard deviation of this data, or the sample standard deviation, okay, S. So remember, sigma is the population standard deviation, and we don't know sigma, but we can figure out the sample standard deviation, S. So to do that, press enter, and then write S, T, D, E, V, and notice there's two different standard deviation calculations. There's dot P and dot S. We want dot S because we have sample, not a population. So P was for population. Open parentheses, and again, just click on your data and hold and drag down, okay? And press the close parentheses and then press enter. So there we go. There's the sample standard deviation. Okay, so now I'm ready to figure out, well, I have my sample mean here. Basically, how much below the sample mean and how much above the sample mean do I want to go when I'm constructing this interval? Okay, and that's called E, your margin of error. That's the distance you want to travel in either direction of your sample mean to basically construct this buffer zone around your sample mean. Okay, so how do I figure out margin of error? Well, Excel has a nice little formula for me to use to figure that out. Before I go to Excel to show you what that formula is, one more thing that we need to know. So we've already calculated X bar, we've calculated the sample, standard deviation, S. One more thing that Excel is going to ask us for is alpha. Alpha has everything to do with the confidence level. Okay, so it's always equal to 1 minus whatever your confidence level is. So 0.95 in this case. go ahead and change it over to a decimal. Okay, so alpha is always a decimal. So 1 minus 0.95 is 0.05. Okay, if you're doing a 90% confidence interval, alpha would be 1 minus 0.9, which is 0.1. If you're doing a 97% confidence interval, then alpha would be 0.03. Okay, so it's always 1 minus whatever your confidence interval percentage is. Okay, so let's go back to Excel and let's calculate E, the margin of error, equals confidence dot T. This is the function we want. Double click on it. It'll open the parentheses for us. So see, there it is. It's asking me what is alpha. So always 1 minus whatever your confidence level is. So 0.05. Standard deviation. That's why we calculated this sample standard deviation right here. So you just click on that cell, okay? And it'll automatically, it'll put it there. So C2 is the reference to the cell, C2, right there, okay? Size. Size is sample size. So how much data do you have, right? How many observations do you have? I have 15. So write 15. Close parentheses and press enter. And there we go. That's the margin of error, 0.926. Okay, so now that we have the margin of error, we can figure out what the lower limit and the upper limit are for that confidence interval. So the lower limit, you'll start at your sample mean. So you can go ahead and click on the sample mean, X bar, and then you'll subtract off the margin of error. Okay, looks like I can't click that cell. So what is that? That is C3, right? The margin of error is sitting right there behind here, C3. Okay, and then press enter. All right, and then equals for the upper limit, I'll start in the center and then I'll go up, right? So I'll start at X bar and then I'll add on the margin of error. So add on C3, press enter. All right, and there we go. This is my confidence interval. So 7.30 to 9.15. to 9.15. And we can say that we are 95% confident that the population mean is between 7.30 and 9.15.